Well, more than 31 million Americans in 15 states live right in the so-called path of totality, that is, for the total solar eclipse. But for Memphians and 99% of people in the U.S., only a partial eclipse will be seen. And no matter where you are, you'll be looking up and need to make sure that you do that safely. Dr. Gregory Wolfe is an associate professor of Southern College of Optometry, and he's here with some do's and don'ts and also a bit of nostalgia that I am so excited about. Thank you for coming in.
Well, it's exciting, Kanji. Yeah. I'm getting ready for this big celestial event.
I know.
I'm excited.
Yeah, and especially you. I know that everybody's asking you. They're like, so what? Okay, tell me what happens if even for a second you look up at the solar eclipse.
Great question. First, we need to understand what the sun does. Okay, the sun emits a whole spectrum of radiation. We perceive the visible light, which is kind of in the middle, and our eye reacts to that light. But what we don't see is the ultraviolet radiation and the infrared radiation that really does the damage to the retina.
Okay, so that's why we're talking about protection here. And exactly. You said we can either go old school or we can use certified glasses.
Exactly. So the direct way to view the eclipse is with a pair of eclipse glasses. There are scams out there. There are fake replicas. They'll even print the logo saying that they're certified by the International Standard Organization. But the only way to really know if they're real is to buy them from a reputable source.
And we have our own reputable source right here that's the biggest eclipse glass maker here in town.
Exactly.
Right.
And there's still time to get them online. You're just going to have to pay express shipping.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So let's go old school. I was like, okay, we'll show people tell people what it is and then show people how to make it.
So what this is called a pinhole projector.
Yes.
What it does is light enters in through this pinhole. And then you look through the opening here. And so the pinhole will project an image of the eclipse on the paper screen back here. And then you can view it through the opening. Of course, you'll put the lid on so it's nice and dark.
Right.
You stand with your back towards the sun, and you look through the hole.
And so basically, it's pretty much just like a shadow, like an outline of what is being seen out there.
It is. It uses what's called the pinhole effect. You might notice that when you're a kid and you make a fist and you look through that tiny hole in your fist and suddenly everything's clear.
Right.
Well, that's because the pinhole focuses the light for you. So the pinhole focuses the image of the sun onto the screen. And as the eclipse happens, you will see the crescent appear.
Okay, that is so cool. And so, I mean, if you could talk about, people or what has happened to people who have looked at the solar eclipse.
Yes, after every major total solar eclipse or even partial eclipse, the medical journals are flooded with case reports of what's called solar retinopathy. And they range from mild retinopathy to quite severe. And if you get a severe form of solar retinopathy, unfortunately it is permanent. And what it does is it causes a fuzzy blind spot right in the center of your vision.
So it's literally like laser zaps your eyeball.
Exactly.
But you can't say that because you're official.
Well, the laser pointers, same thing. It can zap your retina. What it does is it focuses the light on the most sensitive part of the retina. And normally, when we look at the sun, we can't because it hurts. And it hurts because our iris reacts to that light and constricts it down into a tiny, tiny pupil. Well, that is a muscle, and it's like a muscle spasm in your eye. But during the eclipse, your pupil doesn't constrict. It stays open. And so all that ultraviolet and infrared radiation comes into the eye, and that's what causes the damage.
I think that you explained it the best that I've heard it so far.
Oh,
I can't
thank
you enough. Dr. Wolfe with the Southern College of Optometry, that's the information if you want to go to their website, and we really appreciate you getting us ready, ready for this solar eclipse on Monday.
Certainly. It's been a pleasure. I hope the weather works out.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Fingers crossed.
Yeah.